cyclists, and we intend to move towards cyclists because as the world is going more green, more cyclists will be commuting to work and traveling. So we would like to eventually move on to cover both motorcyclists and cyclists.
In market research, we went on Reddit, we put some survey there, and on the survey, 53.7% of the survey said that this was a problem, 53.8% said that we revised food and food products. We also went on multiple micro forums, and most of them suggested that there was like pretty important ideas to how to solve the things, and that showed that they had the problem too, and that we could have in the market research solution. The other solutions that were available that they suggested were to wear like the skull cap or some sort of beanie, but the only problem with that being you put the beanie on and take off and you have hat hair, that's kind of nullified the purpose of wearing it. Or to just shave it.
So when constructing our prototype, first idea was to go to an actual hairstylist, and that was to make sure that she felt it was just a good idea and that it would actually work. And she did. So we're actually able to borrow a filing on to kind of demonstrate to ourselves how we would have to design the product. We then went on to research how the hair was created and particularly explain it. Kind of went on from that to eliminate that pressure that was created, and that's exactly why we have this product here. After that we started trying to find a plastic that would work. Our first plastic was this one here. It was far too thick and rigid, and we even tried heating it with both blowtorch, heat gun, kindling, and we could never find a mixture of heat, well, actually a high heat that would keep it moldable for long enough. And we tried rolling it out with more piping, making it a little thinner, and that still wouldn't work. It would always kind of form back to how it was originally, and then as we see, it kind of warped the thing. It didn't work. Our next idea was to use kind of like a moldable putty, and that, similar to the plastic, it would almost come back to its original shape, so it would fight us every time we try to mold into a specific form or whatever it fit inside the helmet. After this, we kind of went back to the drawing board and designed a cardboard cutout, and it made sure that it would fit inside the helmet, and noticed that the cardboard was already thinner than both the materials that we previously used. So we started just kind of researching plastics, looking at thicknesses, and we ended up using the same plastic that you see on the notebook cover, which is what we have here. And you can see it's extremely thin, so it's worth that. It's very flexible, very moldable. It was able to fit inside the helmet without too much effort. After that, we needed something that would create like an air gap to alleviate the pressure on hair itself. So we used the tips of hairbrushes, knowing that they wouldn't be like extremely aggressive because of the round on the ends, and it would be a little more comfortable than the actual point. We used two different kinds of glue. The first glue was the same